Hello, and welcome to VIAVI's training video, how to use the Expert OTDR mode using your T-BERD 2000 OTDR module. We begin the presentation on the home screen of your T-BERD 2000, where you'll see the Expert OTDR icon in the bottom left. One quick note is that the Expert OTDR doesn't necessarily mean that you have to be an expert to use it. What it primarily means is that you'll have access to every single setting that we offer in our OTDR applications. We begin by selecting the Expert OTDR, which will automatically call up either a blank screen or the previous result that you made before. If you're looking at your mainframe, there's a setup hard key on it, but since I'm remote controlled today, we're going to press at the top of the screen in order to access the setup option. Just quickly going through each one of the settings and the acquisition screen. The main settings will, of course, be your network config, which is whether it's going to be point-to-point or a PON network. You know, PON networks usually have splitters, which can be difficult for an OTDR to figure out on its own. So once we tell it it's a PON situation with a splitter, it'll know what to look for, use some multiple pulse widths, and get a good result. Next would be your wavelengths, you know, whether you only wanted to test a single wavelength or two wavelengths at the same time, or all three, depending on which module that you have. You know, here at VIAVI, we always recommend testing at least two wavelengths because that'll allow for macro bend detection. Switching down to the acquisition mode, you either have manual, automatic, which is basically going to automatically choose your range, pulse, and resolution, or what we call smart acquisition, which is basically going to be a test where you can make multiple pulse widths in a single result. For today, we're just going to use the manual mode because, like I said, this is for the expert. You know, a lot of experts will want to go through and, you know, rather than auto mode, they want to start, you know, they may want to start with auto test, see what parameters are chosen, and then switch on and hone in on the range, the pulse width, and the resolution and the acquisition time. Now, these are all things that an expert user may tinker with in order to get the optimal results. You then have an OTDR connector test, which is testing the integrity of the connection into the OTDR, and then also your launch cable, whether you want to have a launch cable in the beginning, as well as a receive cable at the end. So again, settings that if you know what you're doing may make sense, but if you're a novice user, you know, we could always use a load config. We could always use the auto mode. So these are ways to streamline and make the expert mode a little bit easier for somebody that might be new to OTDRs. Running through the rest of the setup, we have our pass-fail alarms. So if you want the measurement to decide, you know, whether a connector or a splice is passing or failing, you would go in here and decide whether you wanted to completely fail, whether you just wanted a warning, or whether you wanted none at all for the alarm level. The analysis is more, you know, detailed on certain things of the result, like your distance units, you know, like your, you know, how you want the results on the trace, really just how the results are going to be displayed once you actually make your measurement. And again, these are settings that could actually be changed afterwards, and it would not affect the actual test. It would only affect the result. Moving on, there's the link cable, or what many of you might refer to as a header. You know, this is basically when you save the information, there's going to be a file and all this information like cable ID and the location, fiber ID, all that good stuff will be saved in that actual file. So when you recall it, you'll know exactly what was going on during that particular test. And then the file menu is a way to auto file name, auto store, set up your report configuration exactly how you want it. And then once you make your results, you won't have to go back and set this at all. So once you have a test, there's going to be a start button either up here on the top of the screen or there's a hard key on your instrument. Go ahead and hit start. You know, like I said, the trace screen will actually show a result as the test is being made. You know, again, this may be the screen that a more expert user would like to look at, you know, because it gives you the waveform. It allows you to zoom in on certain events, allows you to use the cursors. But then again, we also have our mapping software, which is called the Smart Link Mapper, which once the test is made, you could use this button to switch over. And this gives you a little bit more of a streamlined process for looking at the different results. In this particular case, we're looking at a bunch of connectors. The connector with the green box around it, if you look at it, means, yep, it's a connector and it's passing both of our thresholds with a good loss and a good reflectance value. Whereas the connector here at 197 feet is failing both the loss and the reflectance value. So trace view will give you the more of the look from the waveform. Smart Link will be more of a mappings tool. And then once you make these measurements, you could go over here to the fast report option and then start creating reports from these results. Thank you for attending today's video.